Hello, Patricerati, I'm Jazz Galati. In this video, I'm going to show you how I extracted this upper right first molar and the root of a second molar you can see right there. Now, what makes this tooth removal challenging and why I sectioned and elevated, you'll see, is because I knew that it had this curved root over here and I was suspecting a bulbosity of the root there. So I chose that because there's not much of the tooth to grip onto, especially as you'll see shortly, there was a fracture, I chose to section elevate. I'm gonna talk you through the entire process as I did it. So after I gave anesthesia, that's me pressing with the handle of my mirror to reduce how much the patient feels from this extraction. And remember, there was a bit of infection in that area. You might have noticed a radiolucency. So whenever I have an infection, I do put some anesthetic in that region. This is me now checking for anesthesia, and there was a loose fragment, the tooth is cracked. So before I start my extraction, I'm actually removing the loose fragment because I don't want that to get inhaled or swallowed or whatever. So anything loose, I get rid of first. I first get a scalpel, I remove a bit of soft tissue overlying that retained root of the upright seven. In the past, I tried to just, you know, go through the soft tissue and try and just luxate the root out, but there's a soft tissue impaction there. If you just quickly get rid of the soft tissue like I showed you there, obviously this video is 2x speed, it makes it so much easier to remove. So even then it was getting hung up by the soft tissue, but I managed to remove it. Now I'm getting my electric handpiece, which got a 45 degree angle. This handpiece is brilliant for wisdom teeth and whatnot. So I use this, it's electric, it's not air driven, and I'm doing my sectioning. So I know I've got my section, the mesiobuccal and distobuccal roots have been sectioned. And as you can see from here, and 2x speed, I'm making like a T shape or a Mercedes shape, whichever way you want to think about it. It's got a bit of a slant to it. And then I start luxating. And the root you remove first is whichever one wants to come out first. So you see straight away, it's the palatal root that's becoming mobile first. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove that, a bit of rotation, it comes out nicely. It also confirms that my section was a good one. Like in my early days of extractions, my sectioning was hit or miss. I wasn't that good, but from practice, my sectioning got better. So now I'm gonna remove the distobuccal because I'm doing some rotation movements with my root forceps, and that's gonna come out very, very nicely as you see here. This is where I came into a challenge. Because of that curve that it had, I was applying some rotational movements and the actual crown broke off. So now it's leaving some roots behind. So don't panic here. I didn't panic. I just had a look, got the area nice and clean, got some nice visualization, removed another fragment. So let's take a look here. You can see the root quite clearly and that curve is stopping it from coming out. So what I did is I removed some facation bone. So I didn't remove anything buccal. I don't want to touch the buccal bone. I removed the facation bone. And just by removing the little bit of that facation bone, I was able to deliver that root. I'm now curettaging, making sure that everything's nice and clean. There's no debris, there's no root dentine, no fractured tooth inside, and you can see how clean of a job that is. Hope you find that extraction video useful. I'm a GDP, I like to section and elevate molars. I'd say about 80% of all molars that I extract, I section them first. I think it's a great skill to learn as a GDP. I am not a specialist oral surgeon. So if any of the techniques you saw in this video is something that a specialist oral surgeon disagrees with, or a specialist oral surgeon has told you to do it a different way to me, they're probably right. I'm probably wrong, but this works in my hands and I'm just sharing. So there's some things that I teach and I'm passionate about. There's some things which I found that, hey, it would have been nice if I had access to a video like this when I was struggling with extraction. So I hope you found this video useful of a way to remove teeth like molars, like the one you saw with a curve in it, through sectioning and elevating without raising a flap. If you like this video, please do subscribe and hit the like below and comment. Let me know so I can keep making more videos like this. Let me know what kind of procedural videos you'd like. Thank you so much for tuning in.